Distinguished listener, and of course, the Federation, my special assistant. Would be recognized and they would take their officially stuck place by way of setting their job, the order of protocol. Let us just go straight to to a speech recognized. And having said that, may we... Distinguished senators, a representative of the Honorable Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, our keynote speaker, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, my name is Cyril Stover, and I welcome you to this official launch of the reform of the Nigerian copyright system with the theme Protecting Creativity for Enhanced Economic Growth. To harness the potentials of creativity for national development, and the mission statement, which is also to advance the growth of the creative industry in Nigeria through the dissemination of corporate knowledge, efficient administration, and protection of rights, then the significance of today's event becomes apt. Therefore, as we officially set this event going, I invite you all to sit back and watch this brief documentary on the Nigerian Copyright Commission, the servitor for today's event. Ladies and gentlemen, let's watch this documentary on the NCC. Thank you.
Channels of commerce and therefore undermining the distribution of legitimate programs.
Piracy is a canker that has been deep into the fabric of the economy of this nation. Somebody uses his internet to deliver you some of the
And raising people actually infringe upon other people's work, as we've discovered, is just due to lack of enlightenment. Mm. People are not aware that what they are doing is a crime. Mm. Okay, so that's the problem we face in this country.
So it's fine for people to just walk into any recorder studio and say, can you do this work for me? Or can you go in the studio, the blended copy of the book? They see nothing wrong with you. It has a look, I said it, that is pure steel.
That Nigeria benefits from enhanced copyright protection. Nigeria's creative arts, Nigeria's cultural patrimony.
The office is pleased to enjoy excellent relationships with its Nigerian partners, in particular, and through the World Intellectual Property Organization, where Nigeria has made significant contributions.
The other important point about all this is way of preserving and protecting Nigerian culture.
And a roadmap of how we are actually going to end up with a stronger legislature. And that roadmap will involve a lot of consultation with the relevant industry groups, film people and music people, publishers, and obviously it will involve consultation with members of the media, obviously a key stakeholder, and all other groups, just to make sure we currently have it in the copyright sector.
May we also quickly recognize the representative of the governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria. Chief Arbu Ebule, I believe, Incomes and Wages Commission, we'd like to recognize your presence here. It's extremely important that you're here with us. Thank you, sir. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we do know that there is a Deputy Senate President, distinguished Dr. Ike Ikweremadu. He's on that floor. Let's appreciate him. We also have, as a member of that advisory committee, my boss, being my former minister, Mr. Frank Wiggy Jr. I believe that he's at the door. I saw him just a few moments ago before the commencement of this event. So, we also have on the committee Jaman and Nikulaku. Let's appreciate him. Also on the advisory committee is Professor Ben Angwe. So, and of course, as we had announced earlier, Chief Ahu Ibuli MFR, you're welcome. These are members of the Reform Advisory Committee. And now, ladies and gentlemen, may I humbly.
Hello. I'm also quite pleased with the turnout. I never quite suspected that many people to be here today, but I'm very pleased that most people made the effort to make it. I know people obviously are busy, got busy lives, but as I said, I wish to thank everyone for making that effort this morning to make it here today. As the MC said, I'm going to go straight into my speech without wasting much time, because I know the General is off to Lagos for another occasion. So I don't wish to keep him too long, or longer than he has to be here. So I'm going to go straight into my speech. I'm sincerely delighted to welcome you all to this occasion of the official launch of the reform of the Nigerian copyright system. I wish to welcome, in a special way, the chairman of this occasion, His Excellency General Yakubu Gowon, GCFR, who accepted our invitation at very short notice. Head of State and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces that the first indigenous copyright statute was actually 18 years thereafter, the current copyright statute was promulgated as a copyright decree number 47 of 1988, now codified as Copyright Act CAP C28, Laws of the Federation of Nigeria, 2004. The latter made provisions for the establishment of the Nigerian Copyright Commission as the sole government agency with responsibility for the administration, regulation, and enforcement of copyright law in this country. Permit me to convey the felicitations of the management and staff of the Nigerian Copyright Commission to Mr. Chairman, who recently celebrated his 78th birthday. I can't believe he looks the way he does at 78. I'm not sure that any of us can look exactly like that when we turn 78. Mr. Chairman, obviously congratulations on attaining that feat, and we obviously wish you more exciting years ahead, God's protection, and good health. Congratulations, sir. I'm highly honored to welcome the special guest of honor at this event, Mohammed fellow advocate, SANCFR, the Honourable Attorney General of the Federation of Minister of Justice, who can't be here today because he's is tied up somewhere else, but he's ably represented by one of his special assistants in the name of Mr. Pius Ote. The agent. The Honourable Attorney General of the Federation's acceptance of the Commission's invitation underscores his deep passion and support for the creative industry in Nigeria. The President's administration, under the able leadership of Mr. President, has already made significant intervention to strengthen the copyright sector to expand its productive capacity. I wish therefore to use this opportunity to assure His Excellency that this initiative to reform the Nigerian copyright system is directly as a result of His Excellency's leadership, which has emphasized a transformation agenda. I welcome all special guests at this occasion, distinguished members of the National Assembly here present, honorable ministers or their representatives, the Chief Judge of the Federal High Court, members of the Diplomatic Corps, Chief Executives of government agencies, captains of industry, representatives of associations of authors and rights owners in the copyright sector, representatives of the various media houses, and our partners, who are partners of the Commission. We thank you all for accepting our invitation to be part of this event, which marks a very new beginning for policy re-engineering in ensuring the protection and dissemination of creative works to enhance the public welfare and encourage innovation by all sectors of the Nigerian economy. It is a general knowledge that technological revolution of the latter part of the 20th century has created a fundamental transformation of the productive enterprise and the global economic landscape. The rapid worldwide proliferation of digital technologies, which facilitates seamless access, transfer, utilization, and distribution of information and data, has engendered a global boom in creative outputs, fostering new business models, as well as an explosive growth of traditional and newly cultivated creative industries, including film, music, publishing, broadcasting, design, and software industries. Predictably, the contributions of these creative industries to gross domestic product, GDP, of many countries have risen significantly, but I'm not sure we can say the same about our dear country, Nigeria, where the contributions of the creative industry has been pretty dismal. This is notwithstanding the explosion in the growth of our music and film industry in the last two decades. Let me say, one of the factors mostly cited as making it difficult for Nigeria to capitalize on its tremendous creative potential is the weakness of its copyright system as the principal policy tool designed to facilitate beneficial market transactions structured around the array of rights recognized under the Copyright Act. In realization of the foregoing, the Nigerian Copyright Commission has therefore initiated this process of reform necessary to reposition Nigeria's creative industries for greater growth that would facilitate access to new markets and strengthen the capacity of the various creative sectors to compete more effectively in the global marketplace. A modernized and transformational national copyright regime has envisaged in the outcome of the reform would provide a platform for the creation, commercialization, and broad diffusion of new knowledge while enabling Nigerian businesses to profit from expanding global trade in cultural goods, which is currently heavily skewed in favor of countries with more advanced copyright systems. The reform process has been designed to enhance coordination of Nigeria's innovation strategy across the key policy institutions, including educational, information technology, science and technology institutions, the Commission considered it necessary to publicly launch the commencement of this reform process in order to bring key stakeholders together with a view to formally presenting the roadmap of the reform process and to secure their critical endorsement. It is pertinent to mention here that the reform process will be managed by an expert group, and by an expert working group made up of experienced persons drawn from within the staff of the Commission and the relevant experts from outside the Commission. The Commission also deemed it necessary to put in place an advisory committee which the MC ran through its members, people, obviously eminent Nigerians, and in strategic positions and policy and leadership framework of this country. The advisory committee should meet periodically to review the activities of the reform process and also prefer useful guidance to the expert working group on implementation of the reform roadmap. The committee will be inaugurated in the course of this event by the chairman of this occasion, General Yakubu Gowon, GCFR, at which point members will be duly introduced. I suppose we've already introduced the members anyway, but they'll be reintroduced. I wish to use this opportunity to thank the members of the advisory committee for accepting to make their experiences and goodwill available to the Commission for this important project. This reform process, I must stress, is of critical importance to Nigeria. It has become inevitable due to the new technological advancements and the increasing value of our cultural industries. Nigeria is well known globally for her tremendous trove of human talent, from movies to the arts, from science to literature. The reform initiative is directed at securing this treasure and establishing a framework to support and reward our creators. The NCC is committed to a reform process that is transparent, accessible to the public, and that reflects the comments and contributions of all areas of the national economy. Therefore, I solicit the support and cooperation of all stakeholders, partners, relevant ministries and agencies of government to ensure that this reform process achieves its set objectives. The Commission welcomes all constructive suggestions and engagements that will help in implementing the roadmap. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, I welcome you and wish you a very happy event. Thank you very much.
In the Nigerian music industry, and I have known a gentleman. He's got a voice that I envy, you know.
I don't run anymore. The reason I rock and run away, now make me for rock another day. Oh, if you face me, I
face you.
Oh, I would have loved to do a song like Only Mole Ayere. So don't take a smile away. Only Alabama red. From today, your wedding day. Oh, Rukati, down on up. The old Olu Feremu. Cause I need to lay a titi.
But today, I have a new song and a new lingo. It's like we're beginning to forget in Nigeria that we're all brothers and sisters. You know, we do not love each other, tolerate each other like we used to. I think we need to find that once more. So this new lingo is called Sibo. It means let's take it easy.
This is how we do it. This is how we do it. This is how we do it. Whether it's good or bad, whether it's sweet or bitter, whether it's hot or cold, anyhow, make we Sibo. Sibo, my brother. Sibo, my sister. I'm a man of ability, full of agility. My capability is not in doubt at all. Not at all, at all. But life in the jungle is a big struggle with so much trouble if you are all alone. Blessing of his stone, no. Iwoy, iwoy. See what my brother is. We need each other. See what my brother is. See what my sister is. We need each other. If I scratch your back and you scratch my back, we no go lack anything at all, at all. Not at all, at all. Yeah. If I do you right and you do me right, everything is right. There'll be no more fights. Hey, he won't wait. See for my brother. Hey. See for my sister. Hey. We need each other. Hey. He won't wait. See for my brother. Hey. See for my sister. Hey. We need each other. Hey.
Na 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 na.
Sometimes I need a helping hand. Someday you'll need it too. No need to shack up. Bang, 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 yeah, yeah. Shack up. Bang, 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 yeah. Whether it's good or bad, whether it's sweet or bitter, whether it's hot or cold, yeah, yeah, I'll make you see go.
Don't worry if I Neji go put me for wahala. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Sonny Neji belongs to the Copyright Society of Nigeria, COSON. And what you've seen is the COSON contribution. Let's appreciate it. And now, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me at this point respectfully invite the chairman of today's occasion, His Excellency General Yakubu Gowon, GCFR, to make his good men remarks.
Thank you, sir. You're speaking. You want to come here, sir? That's right, yeah.
This is actually correct, please. You look different in your. I have a lot of them. I'm not here, but of this
ceremony. Mr. President, Dr. Goodluck Bele Jonathan, GCFR, he was to be represented by his Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice,